Hello and welcome to this lab, Create S3 Bucket. So as part of this lab, you're going to learn about how to create S3 Bucket. Then you're going to learn how to enable versioning for the S3 Bucket and how to enable encryption for the S3 Bucket. So first of all, let me give you a small introduction about what is S3. So S3 is an AWS service which allows you to create buckets and store file in these buckets. So you can create a S3 bucket. Inside this bucket, you can create folders and you can upload file to that folders, or you can directly upload files to this S3 bucket. Now, what is the meaning of versioning? So if you're aware about source code management systems like GitHub, basically what it allows you to do is it allows you to commit your code and maintain different versions of your code. So same way, if you enable versioning for your S3 bucket, if you upload a file to a S3 bucket, and then you re-upload a file, a same file with some changes in it, again back to the S3 bucket. If you do this, and if you've enabled versioning, you'll be able to see both the versions, the first file which you uploaded and the modified file which you uploaded after that. So basically versioning means what? It keeps track of all the changes that you're doing in your files. Now, what's the meaning of encryption? Encryption means the data that you're storing in the bucket will be encrypted and will be stored in the bucket. What is the encryption? That means something additional will be added to that data, or that data will be changed in a format that no one else can understand. So what's the use of this? The use is basically, if you have uploaded a file and you have enabled encryption, if a hacker gets access to that file data, the data will be encrypted, so he won't be able to understand that data. But if you are trying to access this file by the legal means or by the right means, it would automatically decrypt and give you back the data. So that's the meaning of enabling encryption. Basically encrypting and storing your file, and while retrieving, it will decrypt and give you your file back. So now let's get started. Let's navigate to the AWS management console. Let's go to S3. Let's create a bucket. Let's give a bucket name. Let's say first bucket. And we need to give a unique name. So let's say 253654. Because bucket names are unique globally. So you can read here, bucket names must be globally unique. That means if someone has used this bucket name in the world, I cannot use it. So these bucket names need to be unique. Next is region. Let me select Mumbai region. Now the object ownership, I leave it as default, ACL disabled, and I'll block all public access. I'll enable encryption, basically I'll enable versioning and I'll enable encryption. So you can see by default we have the encryption here. Server side encryption is automatically applied to new objects stored in this bucket, and you can have encryption key type as Amazon S3 managed keys. So I'll just stick with this. Or you can use AWS key managed service key. Now here is bucket key. So when KMS encryption is used to encrypt new objects in this bucket, the bucket key reduces encryption cost by lowering calls to AWS KMS. So either you can enable it or disable it. I leave it by default enabled. So these are the things which I'm doing. I've given a bucket name. I've selected a region, Mumbai. I have kept the object ownership as ACL disabled. I've blocked all public access. I've enabled versioning and I've left the default encryption here. And now I'll click on create bucket. So now my bucket is created. Now I can click on this name over here. In order to upload a file to this bucket, what I can do is I can click on this upload icon over here, upload button. Now I'll click on this add files. I can add any file here. So let's say I want to add this image. Now you can see permissions. Even if you grant public permissions, you won't be able to see download it from any HTTPS URL because we have disabled all public access. So I'll just keep this all as default and click on upload. So I've uploaded my file. So you can see status has succeeded. Now here you can see I'm inside this bucket, first bucket 253654, and I have one object inside it, which is this file, and the storage class is standard. Now, if I want to download this file, I can select and I can click on download. And that is how I can download the file. If I want to upload another file, again, I can click on upload, add files. I can select another icon or another picture, click open. So you can upload anything to S3 buckets and click on upload. So you can see status succeeded and storage class is standard. So this is how you can create bucket and upload files to the bucket. If you want to delete a bucket, how do you delete a bucket? First of all, you need to empty the bucket before you can delete the bucket. So let me select all this and click on delete. First, I need to empty the bucket before I can delete the bucket. Now I need to type here, delete. I'll just simply copy it, paste it here, click delete objects, and I've deleted the objects. Now I'll go back to the buckets. So I'm here. I can see all the buckets that I have in this AWS account. Now I'll select the bucket and click delete. So it says the bucket is not empty. Let me check if I've missed any file. So I don't see any files here. Let me go back here. Click this refresh icon, select the bucket, click delete. Okay, it's just giving me the error message that buckets must be empty before they can be deleted. In this case, it seems like an AWS error. I'll select this, click on empty over here, and then type here permanently delete. Now that I've emptied the bucket, I click on this exit, select the bucket, click delete, and this time I'm able to delete. Now I need to enter the bucket name. So I'll copy the bucket name from here, paste it here and delete the bucket. And done. Now let's quickly summarize what you have learned in this lab. So as part of this lab, you have created a S3 bucket, enabled versioning for the S3 bucket and enabled the default encryption for the S3 bucket. And then you have learned how you can upload a file to a S3 bucket, how you can delete a S3 bucket. And you've also learned that for deleting a S3 bucket, you need the S3 bucket empty, then only you can delete it. So for emptying the bucket, we saw that when we deleted the files, we were facing some issue. And then we selected the bucket and there was an empty button there. We clicked that button and then we were able to empty the bucket completely. There must be some metadata stored internally, which we are not aware about, because of which it was not allowing us to delete the bucket. And then we selected the bucket and we clicked on delete and we could successfully delete the bucket. So as part of this lab, you have learned the basics about S3 and how you can create S3 bucket, how you can upload files to the bucket, how you can delete S3 bucket. Thank you.